Hai Miss, hai. Hai Miss Leti, yuhu, hai Miss. Hai Pak Dika. Halo Miss Jana. Oke, kita tunggu sebentar lagi. Tunggu agak ramai, hai. Thank you for joining, hai. Halo Miss Sarita, hai Miss Wi. Makasih udah join. Kita tunggu sebentar lagi ya. So we're going to wait a little bit long. Hai Miss, yang udah stay tune dari tadi nih. Hai, thank you for joining. Hai everyone, halo semuanya. Terima kasih udah bergabung sama kita hari ini. Oke, kita langsung mulai aja deh ya. Good afternoon, Miss Letty. Oke, kita langsung mulai aja hari ini. Selamat sore semuanya, balik lagi dengan Sarita dari Jakarta Multicultural School di JMS IG Live Talks. Nah, biasanya nih, minggu-minggu lalu saya suka sendirian kalau misalkan bawain JMS IG Live Talks. Tapi minggu ini, sampai beberapa minggu ke depan, nanti saya akan ditemani partner saya, akhirnya gak sendirian lagi. Kita sambut aja langsung, Karen!
Hi everybody! I'm Karen from Jakarta Multicultural School. So there's been a few feedback from you lately that you wanted the JMS Live Talks to be translated in English. So I'm here as per your lovely request. I'm sorry that I can't see my full face for my first showing. It's because we're here at our music hall at school and we are honoring the protocol for the social distancing, making sure everybody stays safe and healthy.
Ya, jadi memang untuk walaupun ini perdananya Miss Karen nih, walaupun perdananya. Jadi untuk kali ini kita akan pakai masker dulu karena kebetulan hari ini kita langsung live dari music room di JMS. Gitu. Jadi untuk menjaga kesehatan bersama, kita akan tetap mengikuti protokol kesehatan dengan menggunakan masker. Oke, nah minggu lalu nih kita udah ngobrol seru banget sama salah satu alumni dari Jakarta Multicultural School, yaitu Ebel. Nah, kali ini seperti yang udah saya sebutkan minggu-minggu lalu juga, minggu ini kita kedatangan salah satu guru dari Jakarta Multicultural School untuk membahas tentang movie score. Hai girls, hai Bu Nana, terima kasih sudah bergabung.
Okay, so if you've missed last week's session with our alumni Abel, you can stay tuned or replay it through the Instagram, our Instagram jakartamulticultural.school or YouTube Jakarta Multicultural School. So right now we will be joining Mr. Nino soon, our very own JMS music teacher. Without further ado, Mr. Nino.
Yeah. Okay. Kita langsung aja bergabung karena kali ini spesial banget. Kita Mr. Nino langsung bergabung bersama kita di Jakarta Multicultural School. Jadi nanti kita akan membahas tentang lebih detail tentang movie score tuh apa sih dan lain-lain. Itu bareng sama Mr. Nino langsung. Kita sambut langsung Mr. Nino.
Hi everyone.
Oke. Nah, sudah bergabung bersama kita hari ini yaitu Mr. Nino. Oke, sebelumnya mungkin Mr. Nino bisa perkenalan diri dulu nih.
Hello, I'm Nino, JMS music teacher. I've been with JMS family for 3 years and this will be my 4th year. I've been a music teacher for 9 years and I've been playing music professionally for 26-ish years since 94.
Wow. So, yeah.
Okay. Mr. Young, Mr. Nino.
Jadi udah bergabung bersama kita langsung kali ini adalah Mr. Nino, guru musik yang ternyata nih udah 26 tahun kurang lebih bermain musik dan udah jadi guru musik selama kurang lebih menjelang 10 tahun dan sudah ada di JMS bergabung di JMS selama kurang lebih menjalani 4 tahun gitu. Hai Mr. Nino, tuh rame langsung nih. Hai Mr. Nino.
Hai, siapa
Bu Nana
aja?
Juga ada Bu Nana.
Halo
ada...
Bu Nana, halo Miss Leti, halo Miss Jenna. Hai.
Oke, nah tadi kita udah kenalan sama Mr. Nino. Kali ini kita akan langsung masuk ke topiknya aja. A real artist katanya.
Siapa itu?
Ya. Jadi kita langsung aja nih ngobrol langsung tentang movie score. Nah, pertanyaan paling dasar nih mungkin semuanya mamis atau kakak-kakak adik-adik di rumah sana pengen tahu nih, movie score tuh sebenarnya apa sih, Mr. Nino?
So the first question of the day, Mr. Nino, is what is movie score, music score?
Okay. Movie score, music score, or film score is a set of music yang specially designed untuk sebuah film tertentu yang tujuannya buat emphasize scene itu, film itu, scene per scene, terus untuk buat bikin penonton relate ke scene itu supaya paham bukan cuma visually but emotionally apa yang terjadi di situ.
Okay, so let me just recap that. So music score is music that's created to set an ambiance, to set a theme of a movie, specifically for a movie, so we can connect to that specific scene or that specific movie. Am I saying that correctly?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, nah kalau misalkan kita biasanya suka dengar nih kata-kata soundtrack. Nah sebenarnya soundtrack dan movie score itu sama nggak sih, Mr. Nino?
Yeah, so is soundtrack and a music score, a movie score, is that the same thing?
Okay, ini cuman terminologi bisnis sih. Bukan terminologi bisnis, orientasi bisnis, profit, commercial. Karena soundtrack, sesuai judulnya, soundtrack. Segala macam sound yang ada di film itu. Jadi termasuk sound effect, explosion, whatever it is a soundtrack. Movie score, semua music yang ada di film itu. Please, Karen, I will pause.
Okay, so according to Mr. Nino, so a soundtrack, between the differences between the soundtrack and movie score, it's really very slight. It's a lot of commercial marketing, sort of like a business terminology. A soundtrack is a sound and a track that also can encompass a music score, but with certain additions. Is that?
Yeah. Okay. And kalau soundtrack sendiri suka dirilis oleh produser untuk commercial reason, misalnya lagu-lagu yang populer, yang lagu-lagu yang akan jadi jagoan di situ, dia dirilis sebagai album sendiri. Apakah movie score ada di dalam soundtrack yang dirilis? Tergantung perspektif bisnisnya si produser. Contoh film Bumblebee. Bumblebee, lagu-lagu yang dibuat itu khusus didesain, dikompos untuk film Bumblebee. Tapi soundtrack yang dirilis, apakah itu khusus didesain untuk film Bumblebee? Tidak. Karena contohnya ada Runaway-nya Bon Jovi. Runaway Bon Jovi ada di situ untuk bawa penonton ngerasain ambience-nya tahun 84 apa. Kan Bon Jovi nggak bikin khusus buat film Bumblebee, cuman itu dirilis dengan license dari Bon Jovi sebagai soundtracknya, itu soundtrack. Tapi belum tentu juga, sorry kan? Oh bukan Michelle Blayton.
Hi Miss Anae.
Hi. But score can be released as a soundtrack as well. For example, Gladiator score. All the music in Gladiator music released as a soundtrack, as an instrumental track. To get the audience what's happening in the movie.
Oh, okay.
That depends, always depends on producer commercial point of view.
Jadi memang soundtrack ini tidak hanya melulu bentuknya dalam bentuk lagu gitu ya. Jadi bisa jadi kalau misalkan memang produsernya bagaimana si produser ini mau mengkomersialkan musik-musik yang ada dalam film tersebut untuk menghidupkan ambience dari filmnya itu tersebut gitu ya, kurang lebih ya. Oke, okay. Nah Mr. Nino, kalau misalkan berarti sound effect gitu-gitu itu juga termasuk ya dalam soundtrack ya?
Soundtrack.
Cuma memang jarang aja yang dikomersialkan seperti ini.
Why you have to sell the explosion on the track for 50 bucks?
Oke, oh ada pertanyaan nih dari Miss Letty, how did you start music? Oke, okay. Ini selingan sedikit nih, mungkin bisa diceritain, dijawab langsung.
I'm going to ask you again, how did I start music, or how does the music score start? Which one is it?
How did you start music?
Me.
So a personal question.
Okay.
They want to know.
Since I was maybe 3 or 4 years old, my dad always brainwashed me with jazz and classical music.
Okay.
I never connected to jazz. I love jazz, but I feel connected to classical music. It feels relevant to me.
Mm-hmm.
When I grew older, I watched Metallica video.
Okay.
Before Metallica, I listened to Queen. Watching Top Guns. Queen. Play one of the movies song soundtrack over there. It feels so cool.
It sounds so cool. Okay,
I want to play in a band, but I don't know what to play. I want to be a drummer. And then suddenly my dad brought me a cassette, audio cassette. Yes, I'm that old. Audio cassette. It's a Swedish guitar player, rock guitar player, but he played classical music. At that point, this is what I've been hearing since I was minion. I like this. I want to be a guitar player, rock guitar player, combining classical and rock.
Okay. Jadi emang basically dari usia 3 atau 4 tahun waktu itu ya, pertama kali dengerin musik dan awalnya berawal dari musik klasik ternyata awalnya attach. Tiba-tiba begitu nonton Metallica nih, langsung ada fans Metallica keluar di sana ya, Metallica. Terus ada the question it's from Elodie katanya. Oke. Nah, jadi memang Mr. Rino ini udah dari kecil nih udah familiar sekali dengan berbagai jenis musik, udah dieksplor banyak berarti ya, dari mulai klasik, terus ada Metallica juga, genrenya jazz gitu.
Jadi emang
udah macam-macam gitu. Oh, Miss Jenna udah komen juga musik rock katanya. Nah, sebelum kita lanjut ke pertanyaan selanjutnya nih, nanti at the end of the session, nanti setelah kita udah ngobrol-ngobrol seru, kalian bisa penonton di sini yang udah join live kita, mamis atau kakak-kakak, adik-adik, bisa bikin posting di bawah, bisa pertanyaan atau bikin skenario cerita, nanti akan dibikinin langsung movie score-nya sama ceritanya score-nya sama Mr. Nino. Langsung di sini di live. Jadi kalau misalkan ceritanya bisa dalam bentuk apa aja, mungkin 1-2 kalimat lah ya menggambarkan ceritanya, nanti akan dibikinin langsung musiknya sama Mr. Nino live di sini gitu.
Okay guys, that's exciting. So later on we'll have an opportunity for Mr. Nino to do a demo, so you can post on the bottom here whether it's questions or you can post a scenario, a very short scenario, and Mr. Nino will play a music to your scenario live on air.
I'm going to do a demo, but not a cooking demo.
Jangan salah paham ya, bukan cooking demo. Oke, kita lanjut ke pertanyaan selanjutnya. Nih Mr. Rino, kalau movie score sendiri nih, sebenarnya proses bikinnya tuh ribet nggak sih? Atau sama aja kayak recording lagu-lagu biasa gitu?
Yeah, so the process of making a music score, is it complicated or is it the same as everything else, like a music recording?
Sama aja. Bikin music score atau bikin music untuk commercial song sama aja. Yang penting satu, harus punya perspektif terhadap film itu. Harus relate, what happens in that scene? What do I need to create to emphasize that scene? How do I connect my audience to that scene? We need to have that perspective. And we have to choose, I would avoid the word correct. We need to choose the specific instrument that can help our audience relate to that scene. And I will demonstrate later about picking which instruments, which is what.
Okay. Jadi memang intinya yang penting bisa membuat suatu musik yang kira-kira connect dengan scene-nya gitu ya, yang kira-kira yang bisa menimbulkan ambience sesungguhnya dari adegan tersebut gitu. Kurang lebih kayak gitu berarti ya. Yang penting itu clue-nya gitu. Harus bisa menciptakan suasana musik yang bisa membangun situasi di filmnya gitu. Nah, biasanya memang kalau pembuatannya movie score itu sendiri dia pakai alat musik selain instrumen, pasti kan berarti ada pakai digital juga ya berarti ya. Digital juga. Berarti memang harus orang-orang yang basicnya punya basic musik atau gimana tuh Mr. Rino?
So we need a basic in music to create a score or sound effect. Is that?
Yeah.
Okay, that's an interesting question. I'm going to mention a name. Hans Zimmer. Hans Zimmer ini adalah he's a very good, great composer, Academy Award winner composer. He won the Oscar for Gladiator. He wrote the composed the music for Pirates of the Caribbean, Interstellar, Man of Steel, and lots of it. But can he read music notation? No.
Okay.
Does he have any music background? No. His only formal music background is only 2 weeks playing piano. Only 2 weeks. He got bored and he left the piano lesson. But then again, at the end of the day, he became an Oscar winner. So it doesn't need a specific education to become a music scorer. It only needs your passion. As long as you understand, you have the perspective, you have a passion in music, you can learn, you can grow, you can create, you can relate your audience to the movie.
Okay.
There's a will, there's a way.
Yeah.
Exactly. Thank you very much.
Jadi basically memang ternyata uniknya adalah saat kita memutuskan untuk membuat suatu karya, sebuah movie score misalkan, itu tidak selalu perlu basic musik yang sebenarnya kayak harus belajar piano dari kecil, itu nggak perlu sebenarnya. Jadi seperti yang dicontohkan Miss Rina tadi, salah satu pemenang Oscar ya, beliau itu hanya 2 minggu belajar piano, terus bosan akhirnya. Mereka dia tinggalin pianonya, terus akhirnya tapi karena dia punya passion di bidang musik gitu. Jadi akhirnya dia memutuskan untuk bikin movie score itu di film
Gladiator
tadi, dan itu menang gitu. Jadi memang pada intinya enggak selalu harus punya basic musik seperti itu ya, Mr. Rino ya. Oke. Okay. Nah, kalau dari Mr. Rino sendiri nih, movie score yang paling berkesan lah. Maksudnya film yang kira-kira menurut Mr. Nino movie score-nya, oh ini oke banget nih gitu.
This is a question for your fans. So what's your favorite music score?
You know, there are a lot, but from the recent movie, did you watch Murder on the Orient Express? The Agatha Christie from Agatha Christie's book. The composer name is Patrick Doyle. Usually, when we create music, it has to be special each scene. This scene has to be different music. That scene different music. That scene different music. But Patrick Doyle doesn't do that. He write the same theme for the entire song, but it's still beautiful. It's from Murder on the Orient Express. The notes, melody, it's only like. Then we change to. That melody served as the entire score for the whole movie. Maybe you can translate it before I explain more.
Nah, jadi tadi salah satu ternyata yang salah satu favoritnya Mr. Nino adalah movie score dari film The Murder of the Orient Express, itu dari adaptasi novel Agatha Christie. Nah, kenapa itu menarik? Karena music scorer-nya, orang yang produksi musiknya itu cuma bikin satu lagu aja, satu musik aja gitu ya, satu musik score aja, tapi bisa dipakai dalam berbagai situasi. Itulah kenapa Mr. Nino suka banget sama itu, yang musik tadi udah dimainin juga. Karena memang ternyata walaupun adegannya, apapun kondisi adegannya, itu ternyata bisa cocok gitu musiknya.
Does it have some deep meaning that it has only one music score?
For me, that music score very very fast meaning. Maksudku gini, kalau kita dengar melodi, itu kan tenang, sad. But in that movie, we use that at the sad scene, but they use that on a murder scene as well, and they expand that at Michelle Pfeiffer's sing for the commercial version. But during the murder scene, usually when we saw murder on a film, we expect the music to be dark, negative, has a deep ambience, bassy. But on that movie, no, it's just that melody, ta 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 da 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 da. It has some sort of hollowness, emptiness over there. So in that murder, usually when we saw murder, we felt the gruesome in the murder. But when we saw the movie with that song, we kind of, okay, I understand why they did that. I understand, I can relate why the brutality has to happen. That is a very powerful song. That is very very genius from Patrick Bowen.
Okay, jadi walaupun musiknya, saat di musiknya dimainkan dalam situasi yang calm gitu, itu dia cocok. Tapi saat adegan pembunuhan pun ternyata begitu dimainkan musiknya, itu ternyata bukan, justru kita biasa kan kalau kita nonton lihat adegan pembunuhan tuh rasanya aduh serem gitu kan, serem takut gitu. Nah kalau ini tuh enggak, itu justru menimbulkan perasaan lain di mana oh kita mulai memahami nih kenapa bisa terjadi seperti itu gitu, kayak gitu kurang lebih. Ini terima kasih banyak yang udah baru bergabung sama kita. Hi everyone, thank you for joining us.
Hi.
If you have any questions, boleh langsung drop questionsnya di bawah. Ini ada, oh ada komen Hans Zimmer dong Pak Nino. Hans Zimmer dong Pak Nino. Mungkin, oh ini request dimainin maksudnya ya? Gimana nih? Coba.
Okay.
Live request.
Nah ini.
Hans Zimmer, siapa yang Hans Zimmer minta? Oh, oke. Okay. Hans Zimmer tadi udah kita bahas bentar. Gimana kalau John Williams? John Williams itu komposer, tapi dia berangkat sebagai drummer. Jadi karakter dia yang drummer itu kebawa di musiknya.
So John Williams. So he's a music composer that is a drummer, and he carries that throughout his music. So as a drummer, he'll carry it into his music. Is that?
And John Williams composed a lot of songs for movies. Star Wars, for example. Oh, Superman. Yeah. Superman. The Christopher Reeves Mario Puzo Superman.
So he composed Superman, Star Wars, is that
Star
correct?
Wars.
So just kind of going on a side note there, I don't hear a lot of drums in like Star Wars or Superman.
But
is
it is
just the beat,
little,
the heart?
Yeah, a lot okay. of punch, a lot
okay.
of dynamics.
Okay.
Yeah, jadi karena memang basicnya drummer ya beliau ya, tapi walaupun memang gak ada banyak suara drum realnya di dalam musik-musik Star Wars ataupun Superman, tapi dia bermain sekali dengan
dynamics-nya
ya.
Lot of punch.
Iya, betul gitu. Oke, kita cek lagi.
John Williams itu
okay. Ini
aku mau ngaitin juga Miss Sarita. Pentingnya kita milih instrumen apa yang mau dipakai. Aku mau pakai contoh dari John Williams Superman.
Oke.
Kalau kita nonton Superman kan gitu kan? Atau pas udah masuk lagunya.
Oh ya.
Tapi kalau misalnya John Williams milih untuk pakai piano akan berbeda dengan dia pilih misalnya pakai ini. Itu bedanya antara satu pakai brass, satu lagi pakai piano. Kalau kita pakai piano, oke.
Okay. Sorry, interupsi sedikit, Pak Nino suaranya kurang jelas nih, bisa lebih dekat ke kamera mungkin. Oh.
Okay.
Kurang dekat ternyata.
Oke.
Mungkin bisa ditranslate dulu tadi, Miss.
So, earlier Mr. Nino was explaining John Williams.
Okay,
John Williams. So the Superman song, so it could be played in, it could have the same score, but if you use a different instrument or maybe even a different beat, it gives off a different feeling. So that's what John Simmons brings into his music, that he plays it with a different beat, and so maybe Mr. Nino could.
Okay. Yeah. And
bisa mungkin.
Okay. John, when we watch Superman, I don't know. Our expectation might be, oh, that guy from Krypton must be. We must feel the heroism in, over there. Mm. That's why he chose brass.
Oh, okay.
We felt the heroism over there, but if turned into piano. works into a different entity.
Yeah, it's
a different entity, totally different thing. Mm-hmm. It's still Superman. It's still Superman theme, Superman score, but can be used for a different scene. We don't feel the heroism over there, but we felt, I don't know, some sort of soothing from, I don't know.
Right. Yeah, yeah.
Very classical.
Betul.
I mean, could it be, is that usually when you hear like trumpets or brass, it usually relates to like the military.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
so maybe that's what we mean to like heroism, you know, fighting. And...
Jadi memang ternyata pemilihan instrumen itu juga jadi sangat krusial dalam pembuatan movie score gitu. Salah satu contohnya tadi yang udah dicontohin sama Mr. Nino adalah adegan di Superman. Jadi kenapa dipilihnya brass waktu itu ya? Karena memang supaya terasa heroismnya gitu. Dan saat ada adegan lain itu bisa dialihkan lagi dengan instrumen lain tapi dengan nada yang sama gitu ya. Jadi memang itu sangat krusial ibaratnya untuk penentuan instrumen itu untuk pembuatan movie score gitu ya. Oke. Nah, boleh kalau misalkan ada yang mau bertanya silakan langsung komen di bawah.
Any questions please post.
Ya, kita masih akan ngobrol-ngobrol terus sama Mr. Rino. Nah, Mr. Rino, kalau film Indonesia ada nggak? Kira-kira.
Aduh. Eros Jarot, Krisya, apa judulnya? Badai?
Badai Pasti Berlalu.
Badai Pasti Berlalu.
Oh, okay. Pasti Berlalu. Kenapa tuh?
It's brilliant, it's very fast, it's very, I don't know, deep. Exploring everything and the remake of the Badai Pasti Berlalu involving Indonesian singer named Waljina. Waljina is a traditional singer. It's a sinden. She sang sinden over there. It turns that song into something different. It has some sort of mystique feeling in that song.
Okay, jadi memang salah satu favoritnya kalau tadi kita udah bahas film luar negeri, kalau di film Indonesia sendiri menurut Mr. Rino yang paling oke itu sejauh ini adalah Badai Pasti Berlalu ya. Jadi salah satu penyanyinya ada Waljina, dinyanyikan oleh Waljina yang merupakan penyanyi sinden sebenarnya gitu ya. Dan Mr. Rino merasa saat lagu itu dimainkan ada terasa kayak semacam mistis gitu di lagu tersebut gitu. Jadi memang agak berbeda dengan soundtrack biasanya kalau di movie score pada umumnya nggak pop juga nggak apa tapi ada nuansa yang berbeda gitu ya, kurang lebih kayak gitu. Selamat datang bagi yang baru bergabung. Halo semuanya, Yayan Ruhian, siapa nih Yayan Ruhian.
So really when we're talking about music score, I mean it's not just one very flat kind of theme or song that we're looking at. It's very a variety of things, right? So it could actually tell its own story. Is that when you're playing a music score and it's a scene, so what happens if there's a scene without no music score? What do you think would be the effect of that?
Okay, jadi pertanyaannya adalah kalau misalkan dalam satu adegan film tapi tidak ada
music
score-nya, menurut Mr. Rina itu gimana?
I don't know. I really don't know. Seriously don't know. Because music is a matter of perspective. Movie too. Mm-hmm. I would relate that question to, have you compared a Japanese horror movie to American horror movie? The very same movie. I don't like horror movie. I'm afraid of it, seriously, yes. But if we compare Japanese horror movie, the music score is not much.
Yeah.
There's a lot of silence over there that really creeps everything out. Mm-hmm. Really. Mm-hmm. That builds the ambience. They only put sound.
Give me
goosebumps. Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah. And only put soundtrack. Door.
Yeah.
Maybe only a note.
Quiet gitu ya.
Yeah. Minimum. Japanese horror movie. The Ring Japanese versus The Ring American Hollywood. I don't know. I feel more scared watching the Japanese movie because it's very silent, very hollow for me.
Okay. Jadi sebenarnya konteksnya, kalaupun ternyata minim dengan movie score gitu ya, kalau misalkan memang match seperti konteksnya film horror misalkan, sebenarnya tanpa musik pun akan terasa lebih apa ya, lebih hening dan lebih serem gitu, ada ambience kayak really? Gitunya gitu ya.
You have to pick the correct music or sound correct to build the ambience.
Okay.
Correct. You don't have to use excessive sound to build the ambience.
Okay.
What you think is right, just try it.
Okay. Jadi kadang sebenarnya emang nggak perlu musik yang mewah gitu, yang besar. Ya selama itu cocok dengan situasi adegannya, itu bisa membangun. Kayak contohnya tadi kalau misalnya contohnya ada The Ring, film The Ring, itu The Ring Jepang dan The Ring Amerika dibandingkan gitu. Secara musik score film The Ring Jepang itu lebih sedikit suara lagu-lagunya ya, paling hanya 1-2 notes dan lain-lain, tapi lebih creepy jadinya. Jadi selama walaupun itu minim, tapi selama itu tepat penggunaannya, dia it's fine
itu,
gitu
itu
ya.
Kan kalau nonton The Ring Jepang kayak ngerasa Sadako ada di sebelah gitu.
It's like it fills our imagination.
Sadako is near us. Ready to crawl out from the TV.
Aduh, oke. Kita sambil baca komen ada Daniel Green. Mr. Nino, is my guitar safe? Aduh ini.
See the over there, man.
Terus ada Ibu Sita. Halo Ibu Sita. Halo Miss Karen, Miss Sarita. Halo Mr. Nino.
Halo Ibu Sita.
Terima kasih Ibu Sita udah bergabung bersama kita. Nah, kita masih juga ngomongin movie score. Oh, sekali lagi untuk mamis, kakak-kakak atau adik-adik yang pengen coba dibikinin langsung nih score sama Mr. Nino, boleh langsung type di bawah. Nanti habis itu akan dibikinin skornya sama Mr. Nino.
Yeah,
seperti
it'll
itu.
It's really fun guys if you can think up of a very short scenario and Mr. Nino will interpret it with his music score.
Oke, okay, mungkin untuk gambaran aja nih. Contoh kita bikin satu ya Mr. Nino ya. Misalkan oke, okay, katakanlah skenarionya misalkan hari Minggu lagi di kamar malas-malesan gitu kan. Terus lagi capek, lagi malas ngapa-ngapain di kamar cuma leha-leha. Nah, itu kira-kira
is that a day in a life.
Oke.
Okay. So, the scenario is sort of like a Sunday and a lazy Sunday, you're in a room, kind of just lazing around. So, what kind of music score would you put to that?
Oke.
Okay.
Oke. Okay. So basically Miss Sarita is telling her everyday story.
Except for Friday at 3.
Okay, music score-nya. Wait up. Before I start, music score is like a conversation. Conversation between the movie to the audience, for example. This is a question. That's a question. And that's a conclusion, that's an answer. But that's a creepy question or delicate one. Maybe. I don't know.
Okay.
I will ask Miss Arita about the situation.
Okay.
Sunday morning.
Sunday morning.
Is the room in air condition or not?
Enggak.
No. Hot.
Yeah.
It's hot.
Yeah.
Okay. Feel lazy. You feel unenergized.
Yeah.
Okay. I will try to interpret what is happening over there.
Okay.
Sunday morning, which is your laziest moment,
and
in a hot room. But Miss Arita, do you want to wake up or do you want to stay in bed? Do you have anything to do or not?
No.
No. Okay.
No. It's a continuous Sunday, lazy Sunday morning.
Lazy Sunday. Okay.
Oke, ini Mr. Rino sedang membuat skor dari skenario yang tadi sudah saya sebutkan.
Because Miss Sarita doesn't want to wake up, I will add some music instrument that maybe add some lazy ambience in it. I don't know.
Okay.
Let's see. Maybe if I have. Wait. Where is it? I'll do only that note. Now I will play it together. I would lower down the cello thing. Mm-hmm. Because the dominant feeling is the lazy. So here's one note. At that point, I'm imagining Miss Sarita still laying on her bed, doing nothing, just do this.
Yeah, yeah.
And, oh, I don't want to wake up.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
What will I do for the rest of my Sunday? That's why I add the violin thing. Violin as a means to deliver the laziness, but as a means to deliver the Sarita's imagination.
Oh,
that's my interpretation.
Okay. Jadi di situ tadi di music school udah dibikin, itu udah berasa banget kan ya, kayak mau malas-malesan gitu kalau lagi hari Minggu. Nah, itu salah satunya adalah tadi ada music violin ya. Ada suara violin. Nah, suara violin itu mewakili suasana malesnya gitu ya. Kayak enggak mau ngapa-ngapainnya gitu. Tapi kurang lebih seperti itu gitu. Jadi itu tadi balik lagi bahwa movie score itu atau skor sebuah skenario itu memang sangat krusial pemilihan instrumentalnya gitu, alat instrumennya gitu ya. Jadi memang setiap instrumen itu dimainkan dengan alasan tertentu berarti ya. Memang sudah ada apa namanya? Ketahuan apa gitu sebenarnya adegannya. Oke, ini udah ada skenario yang masuk. Oke, kita lihat nih. Skenario request.
It's like
dark
it.
And all children are scared with the pandemic. Oke. Okay. As time goes by, they see no hope, but suddenly a light shines and hopes come and everyone is happy and they go back to life. Okay, go back to school and so happy to meet their friends and teachers.
I like it. Okay, I like the dark ambience first. Mm-hmm. So basically, I'm going to ask Miss Jenna. So the ambience should be dark, right? Should be gloomy, should be negative, but somewhere in the middle, it turns to hope, isn't it? That's what I get, right?
Okay. Sambil Mr. Rino siap-siap, halo semuanya, halo, ada Miss Bell, ada Mr. Ali, yes kata Miss Jenna. Okay, sambil Mr. Rino siap-siap, terima kasih sudah bergabung bersama kita. Sekarang kita lagi coba. Mr. Rino sedang coba bikin score atas skenarionya Miss Jenna tadi ya.
So the scenario is that children they're starting off in the where we are right now in a pandemic and where there's no hope, but then all of a sudden a light shines through and hope and we go back to life and hopefully a normal.
We can go back to school.
Or to school, yeah. I'm almost. Narrating a zombie movie. Go back to school is what I meant.
Okay.
Okay, the dark part. You don't have a hope over here, right? All you feel is negative and empty. And then I will switch to someplace else.
Okay, jadi tadi udah ada music darknya udah dibikin. Sekarang akan masuk ke.
No, bentar, still dark.
Oh, masih dark juga, masih dark.
Okay.
Kita masih bahas soal dark dulu nih.
Okay. Now I'm going to use. I don't know. We'll see. Thank you. Jenna, is that dark enough? Is it dark enough? Hopeless enough for this pandemic? Because we're going to shine a little bit of hope over here now.
Yes, Miss Jenna says yes.
Okay, cool.
But the dark shouldn't be that long.
But the pandemic is very long. That's my argument over there. Wait.
Okay.
Must
see the hope, yeah.
We'll play the whole music. Wait up. Okay, new tracks. Wait up. We'll combine everything.
Okay, sebentar lagi Miss Lino akan play musiknya ya. So dari awal ya.
So he's gonna combine everything that he just created.
Okay, dark first.
The reason I picked orchestra strings, I want to expand the ambience, relate to the viewer. Here's the happy part.
Darkness and feel the hope and the light just with music.
Nah, okay.
That's quite amazing.
Yeah, jadi memang cukup dengan musiknya aja kita udah bisa membayangkan nih suasana darknya tadi, dan kemudian ada mulai light of hope, mulai ada pencerahan ring gitu kan, dari atas gitu. Wow, kata Miss Jenna. Thank you, Miss Jenna.
If we have more time to do it, to make it more perfect, we can, during the dark part, fade out the last phase of that dark part, fade out, so, and fade in the hope part. So everything combined and blend together.
Jadi sebenarnya akan bisa lebih blend lagi kalau misalkan di bagian darknya tadi di at the end kita bisa fade out sedikit, terus nanti di bagian musik untuk hope-nya itu di fade in ya. Gitu, jadi itu tadi perfecto kata Miss Jenna nih.
Oh, thank you very much Miss Jenna.
Thank you Miss Jenna for participating
yes,
ya. Bagi misalkan ada mamis atau kakak-kakak adik-adik yang masih pengen kirim skenario di bawah, boleh masih kita masih ada waktu kurang lebih sekitar 10 menit nih. Bisa ya? Miss Rina bikin dalam 10. Miss Rina udah master banget pokoknya. 10 menit aja bisa selesai. Masih balik lagi ke musiknya, requestnya Miss Jenna tadi. Aku mau nanya nih, instrumen musik apa yang tadi yang tergabung dalam alat musik? Kalau tadi kan aku ada violin, kalau ini ada instrumen apa tadi dalam situ?
Okay, I use piano to create the creepy dark ambience. It's creepy, it's dark, but I need something else to become piano's partner. So the creepiness, the dark part, can reach you. I use strings, only play the notes itself, only play the low notes. Then I would move to. I just use that instrument. If you have more time to do it, serious, put some more effort, I can put some, I don't know, glockenspiel or I don't know, triangle. Ting, ting. That ting sound,
yeah.
It create more ambience of the creepiness, right?
Yeah, benar. Jadi tadi sebenarnya instrumennya dipakai cuma piano ya?
Piano dan strings.
Piano dan strings aja. Dengan dua alat musik itu aja selama penggunaannya tepat dengan situasinya itu udah bisa menghidupkan suasananya gitu. Nah ini kita coba lihat lagi. Oke, mungkin sambil kita lihat masih ada 10 menit. Miss Karen nih, right. Katanya punya skenario nih, Mr. Nino.
Okay. So I love action movies. So let's say the scenario is, let's say we're doing some martial arts, and maybe we're practicing martial arts, and you know we're what do you call that? We're letting go of stress during this quarantine time, and we're just punching it away.
Mm. Okay.
Okay. Does the score? No. The music. Does it comes in between or after the practicing is over?
Maybe during.
During.
Ini agak so film action nih.
So maybe we start.
Okay.
Maybe we start with like a warm up and then go.
Mm-hmm. I would use. Press.
Jadi itu alat musiknya apa tadi tuh, Mr. Rino?
Brass ensemble.
Ada alasan tertentunya?
Yeah. Paling gampang untuk dapat heroism, brass.
Okay. Kayak Superman tadi ya?
Superman tadi atau film Rocky?
Okay.
Okay.
That makes sense. So the easiest way to convey the feeling of heroism is the instrument. Well, we would use brass.
Yeah. Okay, because you said it yourself, Karen. Marching band, military.
Right.
Okay. Jadi tadi kita sebenarnya udah bahas banyak, ada brass, terus untuk heroism, and terus wait, ada piano untuk creepy.
Karen skenario, I divide it into certain part.
Okay.
Karen said
warming up,
right? Warming up. I just use the basic note. But then they start doing the martial art movement practice. I would add extra note to emphasize the extra movement. From a change, you'd feel the dynamics changing,
yeah,
because of that one extra note.
Jadi lebih intens ya.
Intensity.
Intensity ya. Jadi awalnya awalnya kalau pas kita dengerin tuh kayak simple gitu, sederhana. Mm-hmm. Karena masih warm up. Begitu udah masuk ke
berantemnya,
itu langsung beda. Karena lebih intens musiknya, kayak gitu kurang lebih ya.
You can hear the transformation.
Iya, komen dari Bu Sita, cool Mr. Nino katanya.
Oh, terima kasih Bu Sita.
Oke, ini kita udah gak terasa udah mau 1 jam ini, ternyata Mr. Nino. Mr. Nino, request terakhir boleh gak satu?
Apa?
Kira-kira bisa bikinin skor yang kira-kira bisa jadi mungkin bisa jadi theme song-nya IG Live Talks gitu. Hey. Ya ini nih
memanfaatkan banget. coba
kita tes.
Because we admire your skills,
kita uji dulu nih Mr. Rino, kira-kira bisa gak nih kita tatang bikin musik yang kira-kira sesuai sama konsep IG Live Talks. Bisa jadi mungkin jingle atau apa gitu kan. Okay. Sedikit aja kira-kira bisa nggak? Sure. Ketawa misalnya.
Kalau cuman bisa atau enggak, gampang.
Wow. Kalau demo sedikit sekarang boleh nggak Mr. Rino?
Kalau demo. The problem is this. Not the problem actually. Because this will be a brand. I need to work maybe at 12 a.m. 1 a.m. and have more intense conversation with Karen and Sarita. What do they expect from IG Live Talk? What do they expect from the ambience? What do they want? I need to have extra intense conversation.
Oh, oke. Oh, jadi ini oke, kita tunggu ya janjinya.
Pokoknya jam 1 jam 2 pagi.
Ya, jadi nanti kita tunggu jingle original untuk JMS IG Live Talk. Ini udah disaksikan oleh berapa puluh viewer.
Oh my god.
Kata Miss Jenna, you need to pay him. Aduh, Miss.
Ini siapa?
Kata Miss Jenna.
You have coffee, very very good
coffee. Okay. Ya, coffee ya. Jadi itu tadi kita udah ngobrol banyak sama Mr. Rino. Kebetulan waktunya juga kita udah mau 1 jam, Mr. Rino. Sekali lagi terima kasih banyak Mr. Rino bergabung bersama kita. Terima kasih banyak, thank you.
Can I say one last thing?
Boleh.
When you work and when you work as an art worker in this context in music, please break the rules. I know it might be provocative, but if you bounded by the rules, you cannot create a progress in music. For example, Beethoven does break a rules, not a rule, rules a lot. He lived in classical music period, but he went deaf. He want to overcome his limitation. He break the rules, creating a new music that doesn't have a lot of texture. And it turns out he pioneered a genre, an era called romantic music period. Because he break the rules. Kurt Cobain, he want to play in a band, but he's not a good guitar player. He break the rules, he doesn't care, he just play. Therefore, that's why grunge music was created. At that time, heavy metal with a lot of shredded guitar player, he cannot do that. He want to get new music. Yeah, break the rules, because there is a saying, a very famous saying. Think outside the box. For me, I think for art worker, it's a very old school. It's not relevant anymore. For me, throw away the box. You don't need to be bounded by 6 walls. If you break the rules, if you don't have any boundaries to what you create, you might create something good. And Patrick Doyle did that in Murder on the Orient Express. Mm-hmm. He doesn't care about the rules about murder scene has to be gruesome. Sad scene has to be that kind of song. We just create one theme for the whole movie, and it's good. It's brilliant.
Wow, that's very inspiring. Closing
jadi remarks. Jadi memang intinya yang penting kalau misalkan mamis atau mungkin nanti adik-adik di luar sana pengen bergerak, pengen ternyata passionnya kayak di sini nih gitu untuk bikin movie score ataupun pekerja art lainnya. Itu yang penting break the rules. Jadi yang penting berani aja gitu ya. Apapun maksudnya teori-teori apapun yang pernah dipelajari itu
tabrak
aja pokoknya ya. Jadi ini oh kita lihat nih ini ada komen dari Ibu Sita, I witness this talk ya.
Halo Bu. Oh, Sarita and Karen will break the rules, Bu, not me. I'm only in music, but Karen.
We'll wait for the theme song of JMS Live Friday Talk. Okay, Juri. Hi, Juri.
Oh, hi, Juri. Where's Juri? Okay. Hi.
Miss Jenna. Okay. Udah, tinggal 5 menit lagi nih. Bentar lagi mati soalnya IG Live-nya. Nah, okay, sekali lagi terima kasih banyak, Mr. Rino. Udah bergabung bersama kita. Terima kasih banyak. Thank you semuanya. Nah, bagi nanti mami atau kakak-kakak adik-adik yang ketinggalan tadi enggak terlalu nyimak di awalnya kayak gimana atau beberapa di tengah-tengah. Jangan khawatir karena nanti video ini akan ke-save dan akan diposting di Instagram JMS di @jakartamulticultural.school di bagian IGTV dan juga nanti minggu depan akan kita posting di official YouTube-nya Jakarta Multicultural School.
That's right, guys. If you missed the session or you kind of just jumped right into the middle session and you want to see the whole video, we'll save it. We'll upload it on our Instagram. So at Instagram at jakartamulticultural.school or our YouTube at jakartamulticultural.school. So don't worry. Please visit our YouTube and like our Instagram. And we will see you for the next one, for the next session.
Nah, minggu depan kita juga akan ngobrol yang gak kalah serunya nih pastinya. Rencananya kita akan membahas tentang new normal. Nah, ada apa nih dengan new normal ini? Nah, pastinya akan berkaitan dengan dunia pendidikan. Di sekolah tuh gimana nih new normal gitu. Jadi nanti bagi mamis yang mungkin pengen banget nyimak nih, tertarik karena ini kan bahas tentang new normal di sekolah. Nah, kita akan bahas minggu depan. Yang kita itu pembicara akan sangat spesial pokoknya. Jadi tunggu aja nanti akan kita update di Instagram Jakarta Multicultural School.
Yeah, sorry guys. Next week will be a very interesting session about the new normal. It's It's about discussing what we're living, our reality right now. And of course, because we're at Jakarta Multicultural School, the new normal relates to education. And for those mommies out there, you don't want to miss this, relating to school, education, and how it'll affect your children. So we will have a very, very special guest for next week.
Very special. Stay tuned informasinya. Yeah. Okay, sekali lagi. Kita tutup dulu acaranya, balik lagi nanti minggu depan dengan saya Sarita dan partner saya Karen. Dan juga ada Mr. Rino, terima kasih banyak Mr. Rino. Oke, thank you everyone semuanya, terima kasih sudah bergabung bersama kita. Dadah, bye.